press to make a table.
I'm actually not going to make it.
I'm going to refurbish this one. It's too big for what we need. We have like a breakfast nook in the house. And it was too big when we purchased for that area. So what I'm going to do is make this a square table. So I'm going to take 2 foot off of this 5 foot long table. I also have to shorten these down to roughly somewhere here, so the same size as the sides. And then that way this hole stays in it and located, so I don't have to drill these holes. I'm just trying to make this as easy as possible for me. I need to get this done by Christmas. I know you're all watching this after Christmas. I have to get all the hardware out of it. One of these pieces, this one here, is all busted up, so I might use a piece of whatever's left over and redo this piece. I need to get this sanded down, try to match the color of the chairs we have. And then I also want to do kind of a river table. It's not going to be the traditional one where they pour it and you can see through it. I'm just going to kind of fake it through the table. Let me get all the staples and the hardware and everything out of here. Alright, so since there's already a finish on it, it's probably going to load up. I'm going to start with 60 grit, go to 80 and 120 and then on up so I can get this finish off. I'm going to do both sides. I had one of those self-feeding belt sanders, but I don't. This is going to take a bit. All right, so change of plans. We're going to do, I don't know, the whole top in resin. I've never done it. I'm obviously going to use a turbo. I have help. I've recruited Jessica. Friends of mine, they come out to hang out pre-Christmas party. You might be doing a little bit of Christmas partying. Okay, let's stop all that right now. That didn't work out so well. So, a couple pictures of, you know, the whole day I took getting that epoxy off after we screwed it up. So, note to self, heat gun takes it off fairly easy. And don't stand around talking for, you know, 45 minutes before you use it. Oops. So anyways, plan C. This is actually just the underside. The other side is fine. We'll flip it over. But what I'm going to do now, we've watched a few videos. My help's going to come back and help me do this because she's interested in doing this. She does the paints and the dirty pores and that, but she's interested in working with the resin. So I have a dark base coat that I'm going to use after watching a few videos. So I'm going to put that on just far enough in that it's inside. So let that dry. I'm going to flip it and put that color on the other side. And then we're going to try this pour thing again. I wanted to get away with one coat on this and it doesn't appear I'm going to.
Yeah, it had like three different size legs on it, so I'm
going to have to
probably loosen the bolts in that and put some pads on it anyways.
Thank you.
So, unfortunately, Jessica couldn't make it. Scheduling conflicts, things like that. So as you noticed, my wife helped. I tried to leave the whole thing in there so we sound like chipmunks. I could have sped it up and put music in. But trying to keep the video short. Okay, so there you go. We do get some drips along the bottom. We thought it was done moving. Apparently it wasn't. And it, I don't know if you can catch it. There's some fuzzies and dimples in it. I don't know if they were air pockets and that coming up, but this is what we ended up with. I can't keep the lights off of it. And for the most part, I'm happy with it. Like, there are, like, you see that dimple right? Get it right there-ish. There's quite a few of those, and there were some pretty big gouges in it from when I took the first layer of resin off. So I think another thin coat of just clear on it, a quick sand in to try to get some of the fuzzies out of it, and as soon as I figure out how to cover it so I don't get any more in it while it sets up. It didn't turn out too bad. A little more color in it than I was gonna put in it, but it looks okay. I like how the color's separated. This is really, really cool. and then over here is really cool. It's kind of like everywhere you look is really kind of cool. But there you have it. I know this is after Christmas, but I need that for Christmas Day. And then I got another project I'm working on. This guy here, you see him. I'm doing that as a video too. And actually turn anything on these two videos. I did turn that and spray it, and I did sand the legs on the lathe. My shop's not about totally turning. And then I got another one I'm working on too. I'll get you all dizzy walking around. Another one of these. Oop, it's not focused. But y'all already seen one of those being made. But I needed those for, you know, Christmas presents. And there's lathe. Everybody wants to know what lathe I'm using. There you go. Yeah, I'll put some pictures up once I get it in the house. It's still a little tacky. I took the plastic off and got all sticky. So I hope y'all had a Merry Christmas, and New Year's is Tuesday coming up. Hope y'all have a safe and happy New Year. I will see y'all next year.